Yes, you want me to introduce the band? That's the easiest. My name is the Jackal. And this is the cameraman. Earn the names that you get. This is not something you can just come up with. You have to, you know, there's a reason why we call him Hellreiser. He reises hell.
Not every day, but you know, mostly, most on Mondays, for example. I don't rise that much.
Yeah, there's only two people in the world who can do that.
I thought you were talking about Lou.
Me and him.
I got my first guitar from my grandmother when I was 15. So before that, I played the organ. And that's when I started playing guitar with him. And he, I guess you got your first guitar from your father or brother or something.
Yeah, I used his.
Music family. There's no music in my family. First generation of groove right here. First 5 years when we were struggling in the underground and nobody heard us, five people on every gig, and we were never in the newspapers and were still working as much as this, but no response. That's when they got worried. But then we came in the newspapers, and then everything was okay. When you're in the news, your grandmother loves you again.
And if you get an award or two, that's even better. Grandmother really appreciates that.
First time you play your oil barrel, you think it's easy as just to hit, but you're gonna hit yourself in your knee or your head, and we've all done it, and you have to do it once to, that's when you learn not to do it again, because it's really, show your finger. This happened like one month ago, and that's for real.
Four gigs, and then they're all broken down and busted, and you can't use them anymore. So we had to just find barrels and steal them from anywhere we could find. And we talked about that in the press, that the Statoil barrels were the best ones. And then we played this one event in Stavanger, which is a oil capital of Norway.
Norway, oil, barrels. Since that, it's been like 2-3 years, yes now, they've delivered 2 new oil barrels to every venue, every gig we've done after. That's like hundreds.
Yeah,
they have a man driving.
They promised us that they would provide the oil barrels for every gig after that in Norway.
The rest of our lives.
And so they thought that couldn't be too much work. And then they got the tour list and was like, God damn, Jesus. There's 150 gigs on this one.
We have to
fire one guy just to do that almost.
So they can afford it.
Gotta hear it!
realized during the years that we don't get any radio to play us, and we don't get any television to show the videos, except for now. This is charming, yes, but we find our fans on stage when we perform to people. Whoa!
Sing to Alexander, sing to him. Oh, thank you.
So it would be better if we only had typical live songs on the album, so we can play every track live, and it would work like 200%. And that was the whole idea this time, to try to capture the same feeling you get when you've seen a Kaizer show. We hope that you get the same feeling when you listen to the Kaizer album this time. This is the third album, so we have a history also with stories, and the first album was about in the old days when everything is black and white, and in urban city somewhere, not I don't know where, but old days in some cities during the war and within the mafia family. And a lot of people are mentioned and a lot of different stories hanging, you know, together. And the second album is only about a couple of people following their lives from beginning to end. That was the concept. The same timing, same, it was all black and white. And it's still black and white on the third album, only now it's after the war. Maybe in color now. This is
partly in color.
Yeah, half of the album is in color now.
You decide. Whatever.
And
whatever works for you.
It's about Dieter Meier's institution this time. It's where they end up after the war, to when they're mentally ill. All with a funny twist, of course. It's not political or too dramatic. It's still funny if you get the lyrics.
Okay, here's a new song called Delicatessen.
The thing with language is that language is only a problem if you suck, if the band is no good. And if the band is good, it doesn't matter if you sing in Icelandic or Norwegian or Spanish or English. You know, that's we've actually seen that, how that works in people's faces.
And that's
so we can say that's how it works. And if your band is no good and you sing in a different language, you can always blame it on the language thing. But then the fact is actually that the band is not so good. So but you can always use it as an excuse, you know. But it's not the main point.
Well, in this case, music is the language.
This is what we call a C moment in Norway.
We're releasing an album here, not a book.
It's a beautiful language.
If you understand music, then you understand Kaizer. I'm
Come see us live.
Come and see us live. That's the safest. We can guarantee we're going to play the songs for you. We cannot guarantee that the radio will play it for you. Not even television. We cannot guarantee that. But we can guarantee that we will play the songs for you if you come and see us live.
Kaizers Orchestra here. You must be Berlin.